What's up? It's Alan B. Charity. I'm here with my boy, Dwayne, for next episode of Making It. Getting ready to be on set. All right, come on, Dwayne. Let's get out of here. Let's get on set, man. All
right, well,
get out of here.
Yes, because
the GPS is going to be late. Yeah. What's up? Here in Detroit, just arriving on set. So this is gonna be our first episode of the documentary series, Making It. We're all here shooting a movie. Action, drama, sex, all that stuff is in it. I ain't shooting that though. I will be shooting the action and the drama. I'm not gonna shoot the sexy parts, okay? I'm gonna keep it PG.
I'm gonna keep it PG with
I gotta keep it PG. I think this movie rated R. About to show y'all what's going on behind the scenes. Stay tuned. Get ready. Y'all gon' know me, yeah, before I leave. Everybody looking down is gonna see. I'm tryna call the devil's bluff, but this shit ain't looking up. Cause the only one I'm counting on is me. God put me with the team. Then they put me in the ring. Now we all working, cooking up a dream. I'm feeling like a fiend, getting high off the lights and the screens. Cause I'm shooting up the likes and the streams. But y'all gon' know
me. I wanted to tell you, but you won't believe it. Sometimes it's not an act. Cause I'm really wrestling with demons. If you don't know the word, you better read it. You think about me, you better send me prayers. Cause I need them. I'm a little beat up, but I'm not defeated. We on our last mile of the marathon. I'm looking, I can see it. Even if I don't, I'ma just believe it. I still got enough for whatever he's sending at me. I can beat it. I'm a soldier, gazing off the cliff with a flag in my fist. And in my other fist is the bag. I'm a winner, coming out on top. When they see what I've been working with, I bet you all they mouths gon' drop. Then them films, then them shows, then them albums gon' drop. Before they ever were a thing, they were everything I thought. But that ain't everything I brought though. And that ain't everything I fought for. But there's a lot you probably rather not know.
You know me, yeah, before I leave. Everybody looking down is gonna see. I'm tryna call the devil's bluff, but this shit ain't looking up. Cause the only one I'm counting on is me. God put me with the team. Then they put me in the ring. Now we all working, cooking up a dream. I'm feeling like a fiend, getting high off the lights and the screens. Cause I'm shooting up the likes and the streams. But you
don't know me. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Quiet on the set. Quiet on the set. Everybody quiet on the set. Everybody be quiet on the set.
Then they put me in the ring. Now we all working, cooking up a dream. I'm feeling like a fiend, getting high off the lights and the screens. Cause I'm shooting up the likes and the streams. But y'all gon' know me.
Scene 6, take 1. Camera 1. Action.
So what's up with the gloves, man? Come on, man. I'm not stupid. Look, you're not in any trouble or anything. I just want to know what it is. That's all.
All right. I sell a little weed here and there. Nothing major.
Oh, is it any good? You're good.
Yeah. I got this regular shit. 5 a quarter. I got some loud shit. Doing 100 a quarter.
Damn. For a quarter?
Hell yeah. Shit. I should charge you 125. But check this out. I'll let you get both of them for 100. Try them out. Let me know how you like them.
No. You don't have to do that. You say it's good and I'll take your word for it.
Look, take both of them. Try them out. Look, I want your business. So try them out. Let me know how you like them.
Appreciate it.
Not a problem. Get at me.
Yep.
And cut. Scene. Okay.
This is kind of a big moment for this
slips back into a relapse, you know? He's got his shit together. He went to rehab. Dad gets him a job. Hal tells me I'm gonna fuck up. I assure Hal I'm not gonna fuck up. I bring you to the office knowing I'm gonna fuck up.
That's how it goes.
That's it, baby. That's it.
When you give him the look, when he say, you ain't gotta worry, nobody watching or whatever.
There. Nobody's watching.
Off rip, in reality, you would really just on top serve your boss, right? So when he say that, give him the look. And then when he say whatever you say, then you can look at the door. Scene 5, take 3, Sal's close up. Hi, keep your energy up, Sal, the camera's on you. Action.
What's up, man? We got to start a show right here. Look at this guy. Hey, so, hey, man, how'd you get involved with this film, brother?
I was very fortunate. I worked on a project with Kayla, the girl playing Linda, my wife, and early on they were looking for somebody for the lead for the role of James, and she reached out to me, and I asked for the audition side so I could look at the project. I loved the project because of the vibe that it has for Detroit. I have some friends that are from Detroit, and when I gave them the synopsis and like the log line of this project, they were like, that's like Detroit. So I was happy to be a part of somebody's, I call it baby, their piece of art, you know, that is so touching to people that are from this area that know this story to be a huge part, whether it's the black guy, the white guy, the blue collar, the white collar, the drug addict, the not drug addict, the ones that think they're bigger and better than, and the ones that don't feel quite as good, and then the ones that are raised to believe certain stereotypes. So I fell in love with it. And I think that answered your question, just in a really long version.
Hey, how you doing? What's your name, brother?
I'm Dale Dobson. I'm playing Hal Daniels.
Okay, Dale, how'd you get involved with the project?
I saw the audition listing and started talking to Terrell, and we had some Zoom calls and readings, and they tried some combinations, and I ended up here, so.
That's awesome. So tell me some of the stuff you've done before.
Oh, gosh. Locally, some commercials and a few music videos lately. Some television, I've got some features in the can, but nothing that's really come out yet.
Right.
So some indie shorts that have made it out that I'm happy with, but I'm just happy to be busy and that's happy awesome. The pandemic is easing and we can get back to this.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
Good.
Hey, what's your name, brother?
My name is Andrew Doc Collins, and I'm playing John Richards in this film.
Okay. Hey, so Andrew, how'd you get involved with the project?
Well, I've been an actor for a long time. I started out in theater. Didn't do anything. I just dropped it for like 20 years. Came back to it when a friend asked me to be in a 48-hour film festival. And so then I started in actual film acting. And I started working with Terrell. I know Terrell for a while. And he told me he was putting together a film. And I just volunteered to help however I could help. And he started talking about this character of John Richards and asked how I would feel about playing this guy who's like just this extreme racist, just a jerk. And I love playing characters that are like out of my regular character. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to pulling this one off. I think it's an incredible script. I think he's got a great cast, and I'm really looking forward to finishing this film.
Hey,
hi.
How'd you get involved in this project?
I had a friend sent me the casting call via Facebook, and then I submitted my headshot and resume and did a couple auditions and got the role.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So, what have you done in the past? Like, how'd you get involved in acting?
So, I have been acting since I was 7. I got started with a local youth theater and did musicals all throughout. I went to college briefly for theater, and then for the last 3 years, I've been working professionally as a murder mystery pro with the American Immersion Theater Company and as a professional princess.
Wow.
Yeah.
You're a princess?
Yes.
Pro?
Yes.
Pro
so
princess.
I am friends with Ariel, Belle, Elsa, Sleeping Beauty.
And
occasionally I do superheroes, so occasionally I get to do Black Widow as well.
Oh, awesome. Hey, what's going on?
Hi, how you doing? My name is Jada Jones. I just came aboard to the Coma Young Project Productions. The project is Pillow Chalk. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. I just recently wrapped on my first film, which is Ear to Ear. That is coming out really soon. Look for it in April of 2022. And I got a lot more coming for you guys. I am doing a little bit of acting, a little bit of directing, and of course, producing.
Good morning. Day two of shooting here in the hotel. Get ready. Go back in my room. It's this way. Yo!
What's up, dog?
Rise and grind, dog.
Hey, what's up, dog?
Dwayne didn't get no sleep last night, even sleep. Last night was a long one.
I know, that's crazy.
Yeah, we is all set till 1:30.
At night,
still shooting.
Yeah, still going.
Getting the scenes. We probably gonna be out there late tonight too.
Yeah.
Man, it's a happy when you shoot a movie. You know? It's a happy when you shoot a movie, dog. Come on, man, sit up. Alright, I'm dressed, I'm looking alright, you know, a little dapper. About to go on set, everybody down here, and I pulled up, pick up the actors. So we're about to go get started shooting. It's a little cool out here in Detroit today. I'm liking it. I just got back from Florida. It's hot, you know, but hey, stay tuned. It's gonna be a good one.
I was about to say, it's crazy because he just happened to be going to Africa.
As soon as you said his name, he popped up.
Yeah, that was crazy, wasn't it?
Yep. As soon as you said his name, bam! It's like he was sitting there. He just jumped out the truck. Oh, here I am right here.
Oh, man, Dr. Coffee's something, boy.
Right.
Dr. Coffee go in, bro. He don't play.
I don't know how that is. Just pop up, bam! What you doing?
Pam, you be doing too much. You be doing too much. All
right.
When preparation meets opportunity, it equals success. Now, before we shoot this dining room scene, we need to light the set. We also need to test out all of the audio equipment to make sure the sound is just right. So before we go see Dr. Coffee, we're gonna drop by the set during prep. This is the time when all of the actors make their mental shift in getting the character so they can make sure that they're delivering a believable performance.
Okay, we're gonna try to roll out real quick, then we'll be back. I gotta go see Dr. Coffee, one of my holistic doctors. Yeah. All right, I'll be back, bro.
Okay. Hey, Allen. How you doing, Allen?
I'm chilling.
I see you, man.
Yeah, you looking like a star on there.
You got a very steady hand.
You looking like a star on there, Dwayne. Look at that. Look at that.
You coming with, you staying, right?
No, I'm coming.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I thought you were going to, okay. Yo, y'all got it worked out.
Without health, there is no wealth. So while we're here in Detroit, it's a must that we stop by to see Dr. Coffee. Dr. Coffee has one-of-a-kind products that he makes himself with raw material that he has shipped directly from the motherland. He also has six generations of knowledge in natural medicine that's been passed down directly through his family line. After leaving Dr. Coffee, I felt better. But the thing is, I didn't even even though I felt bad in the first place.
That our focus is really, we want to get a streaming service, man. That's the long game. It's good a streaming service. Right. Build a base, establish some credibility, and then get our own streaming service, and then recruit these other movie producers, recruit them, let's team up. We don't gotta compete.
Right, right.
It never could be enough movies.
Right.
And we combine with our stuff, get our own streams, have our own Netflix. You know what I mean? Have us 30, 40 movies. And then, like, I'm changing my focus from movies to just TV series.
Oh. I was telling my dude Alan. I said, man, my dude be cold. I said, man, the movie's cool, but the money is in the series.
Yeah, it's the cash flow.
Mm-hmm. How are you?
Y'all having a summit?
How's my sister doing?
Oh, she's doing great.
Good. Oh, drink all, brother. Take this and drink all of it one time.
Okay. All right. Okay. Dr. Coffee,
just drink it.
Yeah. All right, Tune, I'm going to be here for a minute. Okay, hotel.
Oh, man. Whoa. Wow, that just...
What was it?
It was minty.
Dr. Kobe, he'll start one thing about him. He's DC, so he'll start healing you quick.
Uh-oh.
He'll start working on you.
So this it's going to make me
It's just a start.
Okay. It's a start.
Yeah, it's just a start.
Okay.
You drunk it?
Yeah, it's going. Yep, take it down.
Bob and Tune.
What's my mom saying?
I want to talk to him. I want to have that conversation. I want to understand what's in his mind.
Right.
Okay, I want to see what he can share with me and give me to understand that what I don't understand. Look, we got some natural honey here, right here. Law says it's a solution for any colds or anything like that. Any type of congestion, right?
Right, yeah, it's good for like any, when you like, basically like if you got a common cold or your throat sore, that honey is soothing, man. That's all I'll put that honey in water by itself while I take 2 4.
Action. Yeah, I'm We Visuals, man, Detroit, Michigan, from Sojourner 2 Projects. I got a film company called We Visuals. I created 2.5 years ago with my, I created it, I was asleep one day, and I just woke up out of my sleep at like 7 in the morning. I had like $297 on the card, and I just told my wife, like, give me a camera. She was like, for real? I'm like, yeah. So she bought me a camcorder, and I just started filming since then and everything, you know what I'm saying? It been good, like, doing this videographer have its ups and downs, especially the downs where you just starting, you don't know how to edit, you don't got nobody to edit for you, so I really had to learn everything on my own from the production, lighting, editing, and learning angles and everything, you know what I'm saying? But, and I also got a production company called Detroit Sports Network, where we document semi-pro players, high school players, and little league players throughout the Michigan area, and sometimes we go around the country doing it and everything. But I definitely love it and everything. Shooting this movie right now, we're trying to make history, you know what I'm saying, with this Pillow Chalk movie. It's gonna be a good movie, stay tuned. But now I'm rocking with who I'm rocking with, bro.
Alan B. Charity.
Yes, indeed. They got a lot of good things going on, and it's a pleasure to work with them because they very professional and everything, and they showing me stuff and everything too. So it's about us and everything. We're a team now. So I ain't good on cameras though, but shit, I need to be, man. I'm shy on cameras. I talk all that shit, but shot in the mug on camera. But it's all good though. We Visuals, let's get it.
Then we got our crew right here.
the most magnificent film crew ever. What's your name, brother?
What's up, man? I'm Alan B. Charity.
And where can they find you at on social media?
Just Google me, A-L-A-N, middle initial B, last name Charity, like love.
No doubt. See, I'm trying to get to a place in life where I could just say Google me. You don't even really gotta ask me too many questions. Everything online already, just Google me. Tory Barclay. Influential Clay. Like, I didn't really think I was ever gonna be an actor, but it kind of found me, and I'm not gonna complain about it because God don't make no coincidences. So
yeah,
I think I'm perfect to play Daryl because I went through similar situations, like dealing with weed and dealing with girls and doing secret sneaky stuff and just having to, you know, yeah, I just been having to do a bunch of stuff, so I feel like I fit the character perfectly, and I think that's why I'm able to vibe with everybody on set and have such great chemistry. And yeah, man, I say the secret to my success so far is just praying and acting for it, investing in yourself, man. And it's been a long journey so far, because coming out of school, man, I went to Saginaw Valley playing football on the full scholarship, academic and athletic, and I ended up losing it all because I didn't want to be myself, and that's what my brand is about. So I have a brand called Influential, and as you can see, I got this anchor on my head, and you want to be anchored in life. The anchor holds the ship down in your life, so you got a ship in the water, you got the water. You are the anchor in your life, and the water represents life. You got sharks in the water, you got big waves, you got tsunamis, you got anything that can hit you in life, and you just got to stay anchored in life. You're going to have people trying to knock you off, you're going to have people telling you they don't believe in you, saying you can't make it, but you just got to believe in yourself and see it through. Trust God, and he's going to make you everything you wanted. Like,
what's up? You asked the question why I'm here, and this, the reality of the situation is we've been at this like maybe like probably like 10 years, you know, and it took 10 years just to get to being able to actually shoot anything with a script other than just paper. So I had to be here, you know what I'm saying? Dwayne, that's my guy, he been at it with us, so he felt, hey, it was necessary, you know, let's go check this out. We got to be here, you know, when it first kicked off, because it's been a long time coming, trying to bring anything to reality, you know, to get it off that paper. That's the most, that's the difficult part. Even when you come up with something creative and you done wrote the best script or wrote the best book, it comes down to, can you get it off that paper? Can you make it a reality?
Dwayne.
Yes.
Dwayne.
Yes, what's up, bro? How you doing?
It's Dwayne Gass. Dwayne is the culprit. He the one that introduced me to the whole situation. Dwayne, what we doing up here, man? How you get involved with this film?
Well, we got involved with this film, you know, some partners of mine. You know, we all came together as a group to put this movie down. And, you know, we had to do it up here in Detroit, you know? So we had to come up here in Detroit a couple of days ago. It was a journey. You know, I had to get Alan, my man on the camera right here, had to pick him up. He called me in the morning. I hadn't been asleep, so it was around 8 o'clock in the morning. I hadn't been asleep yet, but we still had to get on the road. So, hey, we made it down here. It took a couple hours. We got down here. We got right into the work, connected with the people. You know, we had some amazing people that came together on this project. We got a lot of shots done. We're gonna put this all together. They're gonna get it edited, put it together, and it's gonna be a good one.
So in that movie, my character and her husband at the time go through three scenes. One is a really happy scene where they're getting ready for Christmas and it's like super happy, and they're talking about maybe having kids and having a family and all that. And then a little while later, he's in the military, and like he's being terribly mean to her over the phone, making her feel bad about stuff, and so she's really sad. And then right after that, he freaks out and screams at her and like all this. So I've gone through all of that in real life, so that's kind of when I realized I could do it without trying to do it, without faking it. It was just natural.
Yeah.
What film were you guys in together?
We just wrapped it. It's called He Knows.
Okay.
We just wrapped it 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, it's a slasher. They like to do a lot of slashers in Kentucky.
Quick, y'all, excuse me. Yeah, I'm trying to talk to y'all so we can get the scene started. I can see you two plates. I can't see yours. So, guys, try not to eat as much. Okay. So that way we don't have to keep putting stuff on the plate for continuity reasons.
Right on set, guys. Scene 3, take 1. Wide.
Thank you.
squad on the set. It's time for the spotlight on. Everybody get in your places. We don't want this shit to go wrong. We've been in this game so long, man. I swear we about to get on. Everybody get in your zone, man. Hit the solid button on your phone. Quiet on the set. It's time for the spotlight on. Everybody get in your places. We don't want this shit to go wrong. We've been in this game so long, man. I swear we about to get on. Everybody get in your zone, man. Hit the silent button on your phone. Quiet
here
on the
we
set.
Go, man. Back on the road. And these trips ain't costing me nothing. This all just part of production. Hit Wayne, tell him put it in the budget. Man, everybody read the script, say they love it. We gotta get it done, then bring it to the public. We going all in, we ain't hold back nothing. We know it's gonna blow soon as law hit the button. We paid our dues, I prayed for you and you stayed, cause you waiting for the day I lose. But I got news, first you gotta find somebody that can do shit the way I do. I do my own thing, I don't play by rules. I gotta move away, I don't stay by fools. Gotta hit the stage with amazing to make y'all move. That's the way I do, a lot of people hating, deja vu. They only hating, cause they not you. The old me died on the day I blew. The old me died on the day I blew. I'm over the top, man. I done come so far. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to stop. Sometimes it feels like I'm out of control. I don't know where I am. I don't know where I'm not. Man, the devil got me flipped upside down. I ain't going nowhere unless I'm going to God. Quiet on the set. It's time for the spotlight on. Everybody get in your places. We don't want this shit to go wrong. We've been in this game so long, man. I swear we about to get on. Everybody get in your zone, man. Hit the solid button on your phone. Quiet on the set. It's time for the spotlight on. Everybody get in your places. We don't want this shit to go wrong. We've been in this game so long, man. I swear we about to get on. Everybody get in your zone, man. Hit the solid button on your phone. Quiet on the set.